If a woman is slapping to a boy or a male, yeah, it's fine, nothing would happen. But if a boy does that same activity, yeah, you know, he's gonna be fired out by the bureaucrat. If a boy is talking to a girl, it is considered as inappropriate. If a girl starts talking with a boy, it's okay, okay. Hi, Miss Jasmine.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How about you? How have you been up to?
I'm very good. Thank you very much. Not too bad. Enjoying some beautiful summer weather in Italy. What about you? How have you been?
Really? Yeah, exactly. Even I'm in Delhi right now and enjoying this pleasant weather, actually.
Pleasant, you know, weather. Really, pleasant.
Yeah. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Pleasant weather, you mean?
Yeah, pleasant weather.
Yeah, good.
Like, cool air is blowing and yeah, this is, yeah, you know, beautiful to look, the nature beauty and...
Yeah, of course. Absolutely. I agree. And do you have any plans for this summer, traveling or anything like that?
Because of this COVID-19, I do not have any plans. No. And we are not supposed to have anything right now because it's especially in Delhi, capital of India. So being home-bounded is really interesting right now.
Yeah. So you're on it's basically a lockdown at the moment still.
Exactly. You can say that. It's not basically lockdown, but you know, there are a lot of prohibitions that government has imposed right now, but still we cannot be, you know, do any work freely and can wander the...
Yeah, I understand. Things in Italy, they're starting to get back a little bit more to, you know, the normal life. And so we are able to travel for the summer, but, you know, we have to be careful. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you have to take the test to make sure you don't have COVID. Or you have to be vaccinated. So yeah, you can travel a little bit, but still, I think I'm not convinced about traveling yet. I think I'm going to wait a little bit.
Yeah, exactly. You should be actually. Yeah. Definitely. Right now it's not the time actually, because maybe somehow you would get infected by this corona, you know.
Yeah.
And after then, the situation becomes really horrible. So it's better to be in the home right now. And, you know, taking all the precautions, because life is all about, you know.
Precious.
Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nish, I have got a topic for the day. So
of course,
would you like to go with this?
I would love to. Let's hear it. Let's hear the topic.
That sounds amazing. So the topic is, do you believe in the statement that that men are treated by the society poorly?
That men are treated by society
poorly.
In a poor way, poorly?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, interesting. In what way do you think, tell me a little bit about what your opinion is.
Okay, well,
you're a man,
I need your response, actually. I'm going to definitely tell about about this topic. But first of all, I would like to know from you, actually. Like, do you believe that, or if so, like, why does men are generally treated poorly?
Men are generally treated poorly. In which sense? Like, because when we think about society, up until, you know, a few years ago, women couldn't vote, women couldn't work, women had more restrictions. So if we're talking I just want to know a little bit more in depth, in particular, I got your point.
Mm-hmm. So, I'm just asking this question because of the reason, you know, these days, especially, we have exaggerated the word called feminism or feminist, you know.
Feminist.
In such a way that, feminist.
Right. Yeah, feminist.
That men are losing their own values. I mean, they are not being applauded by the society. You know, if you are having any violence with the family, with the women, then man is the one who has to take all the blame.
Well,
even the bureaucracy.
I would say even like just a feminist, like the word feminism, what does that mean? I feel like it's been misconstrued in public as well, in society as well. A feminist just means that that men and women should have equal opportunities and should share. So what it actually means is that men and women should both share the burden. It should not be, a feminist believes that it should not just be up to the man to provide for his family, but it should be something that they both do in together, and that they both support each other, right? So it's also that men, you know, and women should work together to help each other. It's not just that, you know, men are horrible and women are
exactly,
you know, great.
But especially yeah. Society is like men are supposed to be, you know, an emotionless person.
Yeah,
you know,
right.
People used to treat them like that they are not having any pain in their life, and
yeah,
you know,
yeah, and that's not that's
and there
not
a lot
right.
of things actually. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's not true
right.
actually.
It's true, absolutely, and I think a real feminist actually supports the idea of that. That's exactly something that a feminist would support, is that that's not true. Like, I mean, men have feelings, and it's not true that a man should not show his emotions to be considered a real man, in the same way that women shouldn't be considered, you know, always so super sensitive and crying about everything, right? It's the same.
Exactly.
Men should be allowed to show their emotion, of course. And I think that really a strong and like self-assured man has no problem in showing his emotions, right? I mean, it's a part of life. It's a part
exactly.
of being human, right? It's a part
Definitely.
Of being human. And so, yeah, I agree. I think that for men, there's a lot of pressure to be a certain way, to be the provider of the family. And there's a lot of weight on their shoulders. And I don't think that that's necessarily fair. You know, I think that both people should pull their weight in any kind of relationship or family.
Exactly, exactly. Even I've seen, you know, in any family, like if the boy is doing something miraculous in his life, mm-hmm. he's not applauded and appreciated in a way if any girls, you know, if any girl does the same activity.
Mm-hmm.
Like if girl is doing the same thing, mm-hmm. I mean, she's getting what she deserves actually. Like mm-hmm. the appreciation from the society, from the, you know, from the parents, everywhere. But mm-hmm. when it comes to men, of course, they're not getting as much as they deserve.
Mm.
And also it is being said that when a boy or a man, you know, start generating the income, they start thinking about their parents, about their children, about their families, about their lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
But when a girl start generating income, you know, she just start thinking about her own self. I mean, you know, how she's going to do the shopping and kind of things related to her own kind of things. I mean,
mm.
you're kidding me. So I just want to hear put one thing right now. See, when you consider the statistics, I mean, you know, the violence which is going between a man and women. So even the democracies, you know, are standing by sides of a women, like taking the favor of a women. Even if the men are not, you know, haven't done anything wrong, still they have to take the blame. I mean, we have made such kind of harsh rule.
Mm-hmm.
Especially I'm like as far as Indian society is considered, I don't know about your society, because
mm-hmm.
you know, we have
yeah.
a democracy, and in
right.
this democracy it is being said that a right of expression, right of equality should be there, but
mm-hmm.
I don't think so that today it exists. And even I'm not underestimating the power of a women. Definitely I do understand, even they are going through a lot of struggles in their life, you know,
mm-hmm. yeah,
managing the house chores, you know, and there are a lot of things they are going through. But
yeah.
still today, I feel sometimes definitely, you know, you cannot fight with a woman. If you do so, especially in India, I mean, your life will become a burden for your own self.
In which mean, like fight with a woman, like have an argument or a disagreement?
I mean, anything. If, you know, even if it's a fake argument, it's a fake kind of allegation. If a woman is putting on you, okay, all right. Or if she is accusing that this partner is beating to me, or, you know, anything.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you haven't done anything, still you have to go to the court, and you know, all the times, and your life will become very frustrating, ma'am. It's something that you wouldn't be going to get the justice from the society, because
yeah, okay. But I also think for maybe years, there's years when women actually have been beaten and you know, physically violated and had
mm-hmm.
violence against women, and there was no way of protecting them. So I don't think that a woman has the right to abuse that. If there really is something happening, it's important that she talks about that and feels like she has a safe place where she can go to have that taken care of. But I wouldn't say that a woman should say that something happened if that hadn't. That's just a serious. So like where I come from, if a man is beating a woman in his home, he goes to jail. But at the same time, if a woman says that she was being beaten by her husband or something like that, and she wasn't, then she goes to jail. The same kind of punishment, right? So you cannot ruin a man's life when you haven't done anything, when he hasn't done anything, and vice versa. A man cannot, you know, physically hit a woman. So I think that there needs to be, you know, a rule in place to keep both people safe, okay, to keep both men and women safe, right? Also men. But I also feel like maybe men, I mean, they don't understand probably what it's like to have to walk to your car at the end of a day at work and be afraid. Like, you have to walk to the car with your keys in between your hands in case some man attacks you. You don't feel safe walking alone at night as a woman in a big city. So there are situations where women have been for years, dealing with this, right? So I'm not saying that men don't have their problems and their troubles as well. I don't doubt that. But also women, you know, I think that from both genders, we need a compassion, right, to try and understand. Women should try and understand men, and men should understand.
But especially in India, you won't believe, like, if a woman is slapping to a boy or a male, you know, it's fine, nothing would happen. But if a boy does that same activity, you know, he's gonna be fired out by the bureaucrat, by the government.
That's actually a really good point. I don't believe that a woman should. That's the same. Like, so if a woman is hitting a man, it's the same kind of violence that it would be a man hitting a woman. So I don't want any man to lay his hand on me, but I'm also not going to lay my hand on anyone. And again, I don't know how it works in your culture or your country, but like, if I would say a woman is hitting a man in Western culture, he should leave her. That's his responsibility to say, I don't want to be in a violent relationship and this is not acceptable, without raising his hands. Because, you know, two wrongs don't make a right, right? So if one person has made a mistake, that doesn't give you right to then, you know, you be violent as well. But you should remove yourself from that situation.
Right? And especially, and one more thing, if a boy is talking to a girl, like if she, in a society, if a boy is talking to a girl, it is considered as inappropriate thing. But in opposite way, if a girl starts talking with a boy, it's okay. Like, of course, people are going to watch, you know, they are going to criticize, but still it's okay. But boy cannot talk to a girl. And this is definitely considered a very wrong thing in our society. These are the taboos, you know, which tells us, which prove us that today man is definitely losing their values, you know. I don't know because of it, why, but girls are considered as a soft-hearted, you know, they cannot do the wrong things. It is taken by the society. And that's the reason we are losing the values, I believe.
Right. I think that there just needs to be, you know, a compassion and understanding from both sides that, you know.
But definitely one thing I would like to appreciate, you know, when it considered for the women, you know, they're cleaning the house, you know, they're cleaning the dishes, doing the laundry. I mean, so much stuff.
In my culture, the women and men are doing this. So both women and men are working, both women and men are raising kids, and both women and men are cooking and cleaning because both of them need to eat, both of them need to have clothes. So I guess it's also a difference in cultures. Like in your culture, if women don't work, I'm not sure. But in my culture, they work and they raise kids and they clean, and also the men do that. So it's like they're more of a team, right? They work together. Maybe in this, they're able to understand each other a little bit better, maybe. Maybe that could be what's happening.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. There's like a separation. There's kind of like a separation, it seems like, in your culture. And it's maybe difficult for them to communicate. Like you said, it's also frowned upon to have men and women communicating. So yeah, it creates like a distance between the two of them, right?
And at last, even in the Indian society, you know, a man can, a girl can put on the boy's dresses, but a man cannot do so. If he's doing so, he would be, you know, made fun by the lot of people.
For what? If he's sorry?
If he put on the dresses of women.
Ah.